IVM. कृपया ध्यान दीजिए, द लैंग्वेज यूज ऑन द पॉडकास्ट मे नॉट बी फिट फॉर कंजम्पशन. वी वॉर्न यू, ट्रेड केयरफुली. बट लिसन यार, डोंट बी सो कंजर्वेटिव.
Namaskar, this is Cyrus Brocha. Disclaimer right at the top. My Wi-Fi might be giving trouble, so if I disappear or something hangs in the middle, do not blame me. I called up Jio directly and the gentleman told me talk to Mukesh Bhai. It turned out Mukesh Bhai is Mukesh Chowda, who's just a guy who lives in the lane and runs the whole place here. I got confused and tried to call the big man and of course couldn't get through the bureaucracy. So that's a story for another day. But for now, I have a separate rant which I want to quickly do, which is I called up Donald Trump with all the crap that's going on. I said, let's find out what's going on. And apparently he's using the same answer on the answering machine. You call up Donald Trump, please. And the answer is pardon. What's going on? Let's go straight to Mickey Mehta. The show is called Cyrus Says. We don't have a laugh track, so I have no idea what impression we make on anyone.
Do you wonder what goes inside the mind of an achiever? How do they manage to get back up on their feet in spite of their failures? Do they really do something different? You're absolutely right. Yes, they do. I'm Aditi Surana. Join me every Wednesday and Friday on my show, Absolutely Right, where I use my special tool of handwriting analysis, also known as graphology, to interview high performers and study secrets behind their success and personality. You can catch us on the IVM Podcast app, website, or wherever you get your podcast from.
Mickey, Cam, all good?
Cyrus, I just heard that your wife is not working well. Then I realized your Wi-Fi is not working well. I couldn't hear the 5-part data. Anyway, how's my...
That's right, that's right. You should... There's no need to make any... cast any aspersions on my wife because I only say bad things. And that's how our marriage has lasted because she has no idea what I do for a living. But okay, Mickey, thank you so much for coming here. I see you're sitting behind your glass doors in your magnificent mansion, which you've... your bungalow where you live for the last 1 year while the rest of India was starving and struggling. But yeah. I think one of the good things... I know you want to go back about your life because 200 people ask you that on radio shows and this and that everywhere and you're bored now. So much so you'll start inventing facts like I do. But, you know, for the 10-12 months, I was thinking people like you who have this sort of healthy philosophy and a healthy lifestyle are the ones who probably deal with lockdown effect better than most. Is that fair to say?
I would say, what is lockdown effect, by the way? I don't know about it. Because
I was depressed.
Oh, I was impressed.
I was very depressed.
I was impressed because the world came to a standstill. And for a change, we could breathe easy, relax, wake up late, do our stuff, work out, go to the market and enjoy sunshine, enjoy the chirping of the birds.
What kind of male, what kind of South Bombay male gets up, works out and goes to the market? What the, you sound like a 14th century guy. What the hell? What? Watch a trading. But that was also closed, if you're talking about that market.
Yeah, no, sorry, no, sorry, no. Go on. I'm not interested in sex and sense-sex, Cyrus. That's out of my...
interested in sex. You mentioned your wife in the beginning. You made sexual aspersions twice already. And this is only the third minute of the program.
Huh. No, sir. I would say that I am very much interested in making love, mingling with the soul, becoming one, becoming whole. W-H-O-L-E. And I enjoy being...
Note to self. No two parties consecutive weeks on this show. All right? There's too much double entendre. W-H-O-L-E. Please.
So let me tell you, Cyrus, that, you know, I was traveling like a mad dog and immediately I became a tortoise, settled, you know, crawling around and enjoying. I enjoyed the lockdown so much because my daughter came down from the US and I had maximum time with her. I literally, you know, every morning I could take more, I would say, hours of sunshine, literally. And look, so
but
my
where's
house,
the sunshine? They didn't let us out of the house first.
Ah, no, brother, my house windows, they oversee the golf course of the Wellington Club.
This is the problem. The people listening to the show aren't as well off, so they don't understand the kind of lifestyle you have.
Okay, you're talking about
sunshine coming into the house.
Around some 10, 12 windows, if I am right, to my house. And but yet my house is only 1,000 square feet, okay? But I'm just blessed to have...
But the window is 500 square feet. That's key. The window is the window to the soul. Yeah.
Certainly. Window to the soul to make you W-H-O-L-E. Oh. Okay.
S-O-U-L. It's W-H-O-L, yeah, S-O-U-L, not S-O-L. That's a Parsi name.
And our souls.
Oh! I've got to stop you there. It's going to be one of those shows. There's nowhere to go but up from here.
Oops. But you know, Cyrus, if you remember. Huh. So, Mr. Brocha.
Correct.
Was a director in Indian Organic Chemicals.
Hey, that's right. Your mom and my dad worked together for no money in some small office for many years.
35, 40 years together.
I would think about
that. Cyrus, let me break some news here. And we must get into some confession. There was a receptionist come telephone operator, Zareen.
Zareen, yes.
And she was well-fed and well-built. I used to enjoy playing in a lab. And Zareen told me that even Cyrus enjoys that.
This is a new Mickey Mehta. This is the side of Mickey Mehta which needs legal representation. And I have to tell you that I hope you don't have too many people listening for Mickey Mehta's soul to be saved.
So neither Zareen is anymore, and nor a husband. So it's
how sad.
How sad. But they're lovely.
Then he was a senior inspector also. He helped us.
Yeah, he was a senior inspector.
Boss, remember one thing. Alzheimer's hits you after 30. All before that, I remember everything. Zareen properly, your mom properly. Jangir properly. Everything I remember. The last 5-10 years have been a hard, boss. Really.
Yeah. And last year has literally taken Alzheimer's away from me. Although I'm 59 today, I'll be 60 in August and finish 40 years of profession and 51 years of yoga. Can you beat it?
51 years of yoga? You started at the age of 8.
When I was 8, it was never too late. And I was not overweight. So it just happened so.
Okay. I need Benadryl. I've got this terrible cough. Okay. No, one second. Just segue there for a second. So at the age of 8, what were you, that's about what, 50 years ago, 1970, what the hell were you doing learning yoga? I mean, what was...
So, you know, my cousins were into martial arts.
Baba. Martial arts and yoga, no disrespect.
No, Parvez Mystery. They used to go to Parvez Mystery.
Correct.
And my cousin like Viraf Majra, Farooq Majra from Xavier, strong, huge chaser. So I wanted to work out at 8.
And you thought the best martial arts is yoga, that dog down position with your bum up.
Yeah, absolutely.
That scares the people. I've always done that in a fight.
And thank God I was not in the Gulf country. I got saved.
Okay, but our sponsors are never going to appear. Amit Doshi, where are you? Say something. Help me. This is dangerous.
Okay, now coming to the point that I told my mom I want to join a gym. So my mom said, boss, go to YMCA. It's the cheapest. So I went to Leamington Road YMCA because we used to live at Falkland Road, the playhouse.
You remember Cyrus Avenue?
Ah, where?
All right next to YMCA, there's a Cyrus Avenue.
Oh, really?
Oh, I
missed that. So I went to YMCA and they said, boss, you're too young to do any gymming here. You better buy gym equipment at home. And he said, okay, you know, gym equipment at home. I said, okay, I went home. And I told my mom, okay, boss, buy me gym equipment. And next day was my birthday. So my mom said, look, my salary is only 150. Your dad's salary is 225. And we can barely eat, drink and make merry. So she said, no gymming. You know, your sister goes to JBPT. She does yoga. So do yoga, whatever your sister does, emulate her.
So it was because of subsidiary effect that you were forced to do yoga because of financial constraints stopping you from doing martial arts or gymming. Yeah. And then you finally do something which required nothing but your hands and legs.
Yeah, can't thank Baba Ramdev. So I have to thank my sister, JBPT at school. She was doing yoga and all.
Who compares their sister to Baba Ramdev? What kind of human being does that? How dare you? I mean, he's a great man.
He's a great man. And you know, Baba Ramdev, ek aap maar maar ke sabko yoga mein usko phasa diya, yoga ke jaal mein. And I'm so happy because of him, the world has risen to understand, being aware and conscious about this wonderful art, talent, and our India's greatest export panacea of wellness yoga.
But I've seen Baba Ramdev, not you mention him, perform in an event. Where he, you know, did all kinds of strange things. I must say, he bent his arm almost to the back of his heel, which I've only seen my one cocker spaniel used to do that. But other than that, I've not really seen that in a human being. So he's actually very flexible, which people don't realize because you just see him on camera.
Brother, you haven't seen me. If I lie on my back, I take my legs back in halasan, and then I will put my knees to the ears and become a small ball.
Actually, this halasan is in Maharashtra. Or you cross the border.
No, very much within me.
So you take your knees back behind your head?
and then fold them and put them in the ears and becoming a small ball.
Can you put the camera down and show us at all?
I'm wearing shorts, yeah. That's Karna Pidasan. It's called Karna Pidasan.
I don't even want to try to say it. KBD means something else.
Can it certainly don't rhyme it. So, wonderful answer.
Back to the legal effect. This is the one thing, although I can't do yoga because it means you have to stay still for a long time. Other than that, but I can't believe the kind of flexibility some people have.
So, ladies and gentlemen, who says this show is just
about talking and talking nonsense? Now, we put our money where our mouth is. We have one of the best exponents of health and yoga, Mr. Mickey Mehta himself, in the words of announcer Airports. Mr. Mickey Mehta in flight.
Okay, so while we talk, let me tell you that Karna Pidasan typically works on your ENT and your brain. So your neurotransmitters and your synaptic connections, they really wire up very well for you to remain creative and, I would say, very alert, aware, and full of responses. Now that I can take the laptop a little behind, and let me try.
So instead of having coffee, I can just put my legs behind my head is what you're saying. And I get gets stimulated.
Well, let me try and show it to you.
Please, one sec. People don't try this at home. You can't just put your legs behind your head. It's not that easy. Only 1 out of 10 people can and should.
Okay, now I go behind.
Right. Oh, my God. That's ridiculous. What kind of human being? I'm ashamed. That's wrong. I mean, furniture is wasted on you. I mean, what the hell is that? Really? Okay. Wow.
So, this is Karna Pidasan.
Mickey.
On demand.
To show you the real deal. On the spot, without warm up, nothing. And the only lesson we learned here is you must have tight underwear, which you showed us in the beginning. Make sure you have tight underwear. Because some people will go for free falling, and free falling can cause a lot of pain, especially if you're not yet a father. But jokes apart, so this gives you what? It stimulates the nervous system.
So, normally our body is subjected to gravity.
You're making fun of the fat souls. So Amit Doshi will be on soon.
The forces of entropy. So entropy is a phenomena where the orderliness of the universe breaks into disorderliness.
Okay.
So time, matter, space, light, motion, mass,
causation effect,
Donald Trump, etc. That they break you into disorder, dis-ease, decay, and death.
Wow.
Now, death has no right on life. Death is the culmination of diseases. Diseases are the culmination of your choices. So choose evolution over entropy, and a choice of evolution is Ashtanga of yoga.
And then we don't die.
And then you can be eternal should you wish to choose evolution every moment of your life.
But is there any other person who's lived forever like that to be me?
Well, there could be so many. And as there is a science in Jainism,
L.K. Advani comes to mind.
Absolutely, L.K. Advani. Absolutely. But this is a very Indian civilization.
You said that there's a tenet in Jainism?
Yes, there's a tenet in Jainism called Santhara. And Santhara means Ichha Mrityu, but the opposite meaning is Ichha Jivan, which means
idea of life.
It's not death wish. And it is also not euthanasia. It is that once you cross 84 and the purpose of life is served, mission accomplished, and then you feel that you living on this earth is a waste of your breath. So what you do, you stop eating. You take your family on board. You stop eating. Now, when you stop eating, your attachment to food and thus your attachment to lust of sex. So lust for food and lust for sex.
You're killing my audience. No food, no sex, and put your legs behind your ears and hang around.
At 84. After 84. So lust for food and lust for sex is detached. So that's called Vairagya. And once that is detached, then you stop eating. Then you stop drinking, which means your thirst and quench for life and attachments of life. All the connections.
So you're basically, you don't want to eat or drink, you're saying. You reach a point where you choose not
to eat for weeks, then you choose not to drink for weeks, and there comes a refinement when your body comes to a point where you can choose not to breathe and sleep forever. And this is scientifically can be explained. And then you let go your breath, exit, transform, transmigrate, reform, choose your womb to come back again, or disappear as fragrance and become the sweetness of fruits and witness the whole cosmos being invisible.
Wow. The only thing is, I remember I was willing to stop breathing and becoming one with the universe at morning meetings in Dacunia's back in the early 90s when I first had a job. But no, I totally get your point. So what you're saying is that we sort of program ourselves.
It is progression. So, I mean, an extraordinary human's life who is extremely super conscious, he is away from programs. Programs only exist in the Matrix. If you remember the movie, Neo.
It was too expensive in INOX, so I just asked my daughter to tell me what happened.
Sterling.
Come check. I also go to Sterlinga, by the way. Planet of the Apes, do you?
Yeah,
fabulous.
Yeah, of course.
As a segue.
Superb. And Planet of the Apes, when it first came in Sterling, I'd seen it then too.
Yeah, all of them I saw there. I don't mind Sterling. I'm a big Sterling fan, but let's not jump.
I mean, Sterling was the first theater to have a Dolby surround.
Parsi Caterer. Fabulous. No, I'm very happy. Honestly, I think this paying $900 to see a movie and all, you might as well make a film in two tickets of your own.
I see. Sorry, you must be getting free tickets. Okay, tell me.
Free tickets not to come in. But coming back to this whole thing, so you're saying, what will Mickey Mehta do? Last question and we'll call the others in. What will Mickey Mehta do in advanced stage? Okay, I mean, you don't look anything close to 59, 60. I mean, really. You tell us.
Okay. So I'll tell you, this whole life of expanding your consciousness is about not doing and start being. Because doing makes everything ugly. In the state of being, an artist paints in a state of being. A singer sings in a state of being. A poet writes in a state of being. So that is being a flow of consciousness in the rhythm. When you are, your unit rhythm is synchronized with the universal rhythm, there is a sense of oneness. And you become whole.
So I get it. The streams of consciousness, feeling where your heart comes out on its own without you actually doing. But what about peeing? When you want to do
peeing. Peeing is also being, not doing. I mean, you try going on the pot and try peeing. When your bladder is full, you will get the urge
and the
sickness.
It follows a natural course.
Rhythm. Right. Flow. Rhythm and flow.
But my age, many times I try to pee and nothing comes out for a little while. Ah. That's also natural lack of flow.
Yeah, that means you are obsessed by peeing and you're saying, okay, let me try and pee.
I have lots of time. What do I do? So going to the toilet and pretending to pee is one of my highlights. Why take that away from me, Mickey Mehta? I can't do what you can do. Legs behind the heels, call my friends over, watch this. My God.
I don't do that. I don't do circus at all. Okay. My yoga is not yoga of circus. My yoga is yoga of evolution. An evolution for human evolution. A wellness revolution for human evolution.
Wow. Mickey Mehta, the poet, brand Mickey Mehta, one of the foremost names in fitness, and the philosopher. You can't detach your philosophy from what you do because you are your brand. Most people try to build a brand which is something else, but you actually are that. So now let's bring in our brand members. We'll take a break first and then bring them in because it takes a little while to connect the Wi-Fi in four different parts of the metropolis. We're all, you know, spread apart. But the universe makes us whole. W-H-O-L-E.
And makes us, our souls, whole.
Oh. Now we need that break. We really need that break.
Hey, I'm Zarina, your peak performance coach, leadership coach, and life coach. And I'm here to unleash that power within you with your weekly dose of mantras and empowerment. Tune in to Monday Mantras every Monday for your quick fix and the empowering series with Zarina Poonawalla every Thursday for riveting real life stories. You can catch us on the IVM Podcast website, app, or wherever you get your podcast from.
Fantastic, boss.
I loved hearing somebody besides my mom talking about Vairagya and stuff like that.
No, but what I like is he put his money where his mouth is and did the damn asana.
Yeah.
You know, which just shows he's the real deal on the spot. Never do it. Huh?
Cyrus, in that asana, I put everything where my mouth is.
Oh, fuck. Look what you did. My TV fell.
Cyrus, I'm doing. Cyrus, I've been dying to come on your, your show, on your TV show. And I was thinking how. And the universe listened to me and this happened.
This is the podcast, but the TV show, you have to have a political reason to put you on.
Sweetie, I'll give you as many political reasons and I'll give you as many punches below the belt, above the belt. And you will be delighted. I promise you fun, fire.
Take a stand pro BJP or anti and we can put you on. But be very harsh.
Understood. No, I'm pro. I'm a big pro. I'm a big bro of the big bro of the big bro.
My God. Wow. No wonder Amit Shah and Amit Doshi is now closer to your heart than we think. Better be careful. Okay, shall we come?
You know, I have studied Sanatan Dharma at length and depth. But I am not in for the madness of the Hinduism. I am here for the Sanatan Dharma, the way of life of Indus Valley civilization, which makes it the most ancient, most in-depth, most scientific. Do you know, Cyrus, that before the scientists could call the earth round and declare it, our Rishi Munis called it Bhugol.
What?
Which is Bhugol, geography. Bhugol.
Sounds like kids don't lie.
And before the scientists could ever have evidence that the earth is moving, our Rishi Munis called this Jagat. Jag, jiski koi gati ho. Gati. Jagat.
Wow.
I'm going to, 1 second. Silvery, will you repeat those two concepts for me right now?
Yeah. Bhugol is, because the earth is spherical.
With both hands.
The earth is spherical.
All right. Okay, stop. Don't. It's not a question. Let's see what topics we have. This is what we do actually in the show. We freewheel about what's happening. So, Silvery's got some topics. He'll be the actor.
Yes.
Go on.
All right. Firstly, from Jan 16th onwards, India has started the largest COVID-19 vaccination drives. And it's been going rather well, I would say. In the last 3 days, about 3.8 lakh people in the country have been vaccinated.
What about the COVID app issue?
Yeah, exactly. So, the 3.8 lakh people have been vaccinated. About 580 adverse effects, out of which 2 have been deaths, but they are saying they are non-vaccine-related deaths. And in some states, like in Maharashtra, after the 16th, for 2 days, vaccination drives had to be halted because the Cowin app was glitching. Like, there were some problems with the Cowin app. But still, like, out of 3.8 lakh people, 580 adverse effects, not all of them too
serious. It's a negligible statistic if you look from
it is. I think it's less than 0.1%.
So then
adverse, and if it's 2 deaths, then that's 0.01%.
Two deaths will be tough to prove, as you said, correlate to the vaccine per se.
Yeah.
Because 2 out of such a huge number of people would have died on that day because of, you know, traffic regulations in my case, or whatever the hell, hypertension or whatever they had. Vicky, when in doubt, assume some position that makes us look ridiculous and questions our manhood. That's all we request from you, sir. You're playing
some the position. Of, I can show you one more position sitting on a chair if you want.
Yeah, please show.
We can't see, but we can.
But yeah,
we
can just lower the camera. Your assistant can go towards your groin. That's because he's one of the highest paid men in the world for doing this. I want people, if they're youngsters watching, why can't I become this? Because Vicky Mehta makes a lot of money, and all he has to do is put his legs in the air and his hands touch his legs, and which is not easy as you think.
Very few people know that Mickey Mehta loses more money than me makes.
But 1 second. Does this put stress on the groin area? Because I get damn scared at my age to spread my legs.
This is to release the stress from the groin area, not to add stress on the groin area.
Is that so?
Absolutely. So by and by, as you open up like a butterfly, So actually,
Amit, you open up like a butterfly?
I think the chances of that are low to non-existent. I can open up like a butterfly like this.
You want to call this
a butterfly?
You know, the first philosophy of yoga is that as your body opens up, the convolutions of your mind opens up too. And as your body becomes flexible, your mind also becomes flexible. You only learn to say yes, affirmative to life. Never say no to life. Because life is only possibilities. If somebody were to ask me, what is life? I would say all possibilities. And yoga is the only way where there's confluence of energy completely equated in balance. So Ganga comes from here, Yamuna comes from here, and becomes Saraswati. It gives birth and rise to new entities. So where the polarity of energies complement each other, don't contradict. They complement each other. They are not in conflict. So like Khalil Gibran says, that even in the temples where we pray and worship with faith, the temples are held with pillars diametrically opposite planted. So you need polarities to exist and not coexist, exist in absolute harmony. So it's a confluence. It's a confluence of energies. It is congruence of your sacred geometry with the sacred geometry of the universe. And it is prefrontal cortex consonance of all humans and everything on earth. And it is a limbic brain resonance with the whole existence.
Flipping program, so many big words. You know, this is like bouncers on a Perth wicket. Very difficult for us. But I want to ask you, I've done one yoga class and then ran away forever with elderly people. And there was a lot of flatulence. And I was told later that that was intended. Now, I just, with all due respect, I mean, intended. And then, you know, I mean, really, that's a real paradox, yaar. मेरे को बुलाएगा मेरे को करना पड़ेगा और उसके बाद सारे साइड से ये खुशबू आई वाज लाइक यू नो नो
ब्रदर यू बीन लकी टू हैव इट फ्रॉम डिस्टेंस व्हाइल आई स्ट्रेच माय सीनियर सिटीजन आई गेट इट स्ट्रेट देयर
All right.
I mean, I don't know what to say about this. I mean, like, you know.
So, when you get up in the morning and go to work, imagine what Mickey's thinking. Or make it under 60. Make it under 60. no disrespect. Ageism. We don't want that. Sorry, Silvery, let's get topics in. Any other time like this?
Yeah. Sure. Going ahead with the COVID thing, a new survey has come out, which is very interesting. You remember how in the beginning of the pandemic, they were saying smokers might be more affected, might contract the disease more easily. Now, a new survey has come out which says the complete opposite, saying that smokers and vegetarians are in less risk of contracting the disease. And they are saying this is the first, term?
What are you saying is the COVID virus likes meat?
No, it's just a survey which conducted. This is the first report from the general population. This is a population report.
The health reports. Mickey, come on this a little bit. First, they tell you egg white, khalo. Then they tell you egg yolk, without egg yolk is a waste of time. Then they go back. They keep the science is rounded about all the time. Cause and effect changes. What do we believe?
Cause and effect does not change.
I'll tell you. Right today, wrong tomorrow. Remember one thing. Logic is lame. Reality is relative.
Because you didn't stretch logic's groin.
Yeah. And facts are frivolous. But truth is constant. So science changes its own position every day. Okay.
But that is the changes in the presence of new information. It doesn't change.
What you're saying is acceptable as a philosophy, but what the hell do we do? Because what is right today is wrong.
I'll tell you. So, you know, Adar Poonawalla has been immunizing the world otherwise. Mickey Mehta has been immunizing the world in a very different way.
See, Joyo, two parties.
Two parties.
Full world. Full world, two parties.
By the way, let me declare that, you know, 3 years back, I published a paper on mental wellness and it was called A Monumental Code, 10 Monumental Commandments. And it was published in an American medical journal. And now I'm publishing a paper on immunity, Dr. Mickey Mehta's Immunity for Humanity, with Dr. Ali Irani from Nanavati Hospital, who is a director.
Physiotherapist of Indian team.
Yeah, who's the director of the Narsingh Monchi Physiotherapy College. And we are going to be releasing this paper in the month of February or March. And that is going to be the document in the world on immunity for humanity. But let me give you a few glimpses. So being a vegetarian helps. Breathing regularly helps, but smoking 100% doesn't.
I think the philosophy behind the smoking is that you're toughened your lungs in a way. You're used to corruption in the, I don't know. This is logic.
See, logic can be used like a whore for and against both.
And whore are males and females. It's not a
and all lawyers use logic a lot.
I'm a son of a lawyer. I'm a 1 year LLB. I'm a poor man's lawyer. Yeah. Really, really poor, man.
So let me tell you that conscious breathing, regulated breathing, which you do while you do a workout, while you stretch and contract your whole body, where your lymphatic system also drains out and works like a pump, your hearts, your lungs, your digestive system, your nervous system, your brain system, your endocrine system, and everything gets orchestrated when you work out. Otherwise, it's very erratic.
Hey, but let's stop for a second on that smoking point. Silvery, please come in here, yeah.
Now, smoking is injurious, period.
Yes, but just let's hear out the other side.
You get compromised.
No, I just want to know what the technique or the logic or the, you know, what.
It's just a survey, right? I mean, like I read the article, he said is that they did a survey of different people who have been affected differently, right, with COVID. People who have been infected and what their, you know, what their lookout was. And based on that, it came out that people who were smoking were less severely affected than people who were not smoking.
It's, and the reason being?
There is no reason. Nobody knows the reason right now. The investigation required. But I mean, like, you know, what you're saying intuitively is probably something like that, right? That if you're a smoker, your lungs are probably a little bit more used to getting shit in them, right? I can't think of anything else.
Hey, did you ever smoke?
I never.
Drinking?
No. But, you know, dump charas, start driving.
Okay.
Although
not interested. After all your positions, what is left for us to do? Imagine if we shared the same lover. After the expectations of your over her neck and up under her head, and I just come and stand there for 5 seconds and deliver my squeal and talk to myself and walk out.
And Cyrus. But there's one thing sure for common: we would both make them laugh and giggle.
They laugh after. Because of me, they laugh after. With you, it's different. Yeah, women can bitch too. Amit, one day we're going to do a show about that. Women bitching about us. We think we're the ones to bitch. My God. Let me tell about the ladies. Now, next question.
Anyway. It should be pointed out, though, that there might be good credence to this survey, because similar reports have been published in Italy, in New York, in France. So it's
all the fashion capitals.
Which is where all the smokers are.
I think I have some justification for that.
Yes, sir.
Because even breathing requires conscious breathing in through your mouth. If you're breathing in air. So each time you suck in air, along with your tobacco, obviously your lung function is activated. So there could be some credence and credibility.
It's like resistance training for the lung. Because you're
I'm just saying, in all probability, if you see the probability amplitude of this.
We will start a bigger revolution in yoga. Smoking is holistic to all good health. And if you do smoking, you can everything will be healed.
Is that and then we will call it Dhammarodham.
But remember, as long as on our packaging is you with the legs spread and the hands up like that, I'll sell any product with that. Can you imagine? Who would buy it? Delivery next.
Yeah, cool. Okay, this next story is supremely interesting. Nidhi Razdan is an NDTV journalist.
NDTV anchor.
Yeah.
Very good news anchor.
Yeah, very good news anchor. She basically was a part of a phishing scam where she got scammed into believing that she has an offer from Harvard for a teaching job at Harvard. So she posted online, hey guys, I'm leaving NDTV, I'm going to Harvard. And turns out that the whole thing was a scam, where the person was just trying to get her account details, like her bank details, her social security, or whatever you have.
Online, Amit, I'm telling you from the beginning, you really don't know who you're dealing with.
Well, yeah,
it's really but Mickey Mehta. That's why I made him do all those positions. It is really Mickey Mehta.
This was crazy, right? I mean, like I said, it's unbelievable that something like this could happen. I mean, like, I'm not. I'll be honest, anybody can get phished. Anybody can be scammed. All of us can fall to this. But this seems like something there's due diligence missing on her side.
But didn't we all get married?
Well, no, not really.
but one thing I don't understand, wouldn't she be dealing with more than one person?
That's what I'm saying.
Get your passport in order, the travel details and all. There'll be other people involved.
And why is all of the information coming inbound to her, right? I mean, like, generally, you would have outbound information going out as well from you, right? So it seems like
also the first time she was contacted, apparently, your tickle pinky, your Harvard say phone call, your email, whatever. And then she reacted to that. That we accept, as you say.
Right.
But post that, as you say, it becomes a little difficult to imagine that she dealt only with one-to-point person. It's such a big thing where you leave your job,
go
to bloody Boston or wherever the hell it is, and, set up shop. It's a little too much.
Yeah, and some of the things around it are also kind of weird, right? Professor of journalism is what she got the job offer as. Harvard does not have a department of journalism, right? So under the liberal arts program, there are certain courses which do journalistic things, but they don't have a department of journalism.
You're starting one or something. That's not.
No, but that is. Dude, I'm sorry, but if that is happening, then the red flags have to be, because then you need to know who is the chair of your department. You need to talk to them.
If they praise the person, I get these letters once in a while saying, oh, great person, will you come in to our college function or whatever. They say such great things about you, like you captain India in 14 test matches. All lies.
No, but
believing the flattery.
So here's the thing, right? I mean, in some ways, I feel like this is a Indian thing where we just assume that because we have a position of prominence, chalo tum aaja job join kar lo. We want you to come in and do this, right? In the US, nothing happens without a review process, right? So even if you're to become a professor at Harvard, you are going to have to interview with the head of your department. You are going to have, no matter what your previous accomplishment is, you have to do an interview process.
Zoom calls and things like that, going to and fro with various people, as you mentioned, the dean, the bean, everybody else involved.
Mr. Bean.
No, it's just weird.
Why didn't you call me? I'm a big fan of yours. Out of hell. I mean, I don't even have a good Wi-Fi connection, but other than that.
It's just...
Say for a change, she didn't do investigative journalism.
Wow. Wow. Ooh, the grass. As we say in Malayalam.
Kamit, one correction though. In the article, she does say that contrary to what many are tweeting, Harvard has a school called the Extension School, offering a journalism degree program. So that is...
I'm sorry, but you don't do these things without interviewing. You don't do these things like that. I'm sympathetic.
Scamming someone.
I'm sympathetic to getting scammed, but I also feel like there is a... Like, you know, you're making this major a life decision on the basis of something like this feels off to me also.
I believe it's wrong when I give a bribe. I always believe that the person taking the bribe is evil. What's wrong if I give it? That's my personal thing.
You know,
taking the bribe is evil.
Yeah, I think in 2016 or 17, if I well remember, I was invited to speak at Harvard, and I did eventually. But the whole process was very layered.
Mm-hmm.
It was there was a due process.
Thank you to mention this first. It would have helped the whole conversation.
There was a completely layered process. And just before me, Shashi Tharoor spoke, Madhavan spoke. And it was and they all went through that layered process. Doesn't matter who. There is a layered process.
Yeah. I've done some of this too. I spoke at like a Google event once, and it was literally 8 people, one after the other. Like, okay, first invitation from project manager at Google Podcast. After that, conversation with different people who are going to handle travel requirements. Then different people who are going to deal with you for content stuff.
I spoke at the building meeting yesterday, for which you know how many emails and phone calls and WhatsApps have gone in between amongst 20 people. So, you know, going to Harvard, you're right. It just makes no sense. It can't be a one-to-one point, two conversation, two emails, and boom, you're there.
Yeah, it just, how do you negotiate your salary? You're not negotiating, like very honestly, right? If you're in a human resources position at a major this, the person who interviews you is not the person who negotiates your salary, right? And so, did that not have? I find it. Again, I'm sympathetic to getting scammed online because it can happen to anybody, right? I mean, like, you know, it's easy for it to happen, but this is a long drawn out scam.
See, we are not disregarding that. We're just analyzing as to what could have gone wrong and what could be it. We're not disregarding it.
Don't be angry with Nidhi. She's a very nice person.
I'm sure.
I don't want to get into a Me Too scam, but a very attractive person.
Really?
Really?
I'm sure she's speaking the truth, but we all miss it sometimes.
Yeah. Exactly. I don't know. I always get 5% more for attractive people. I just feel they deserve it.
Oh, yeah. I don't think she's dumb. I don't think she's anything like that, right? I just, it feels odd. Right, I mean, like, there's a lot of negative reaction to us because she's hated anyway, right?
Sometimes you believe what you want to believe also now because you don't want the validation all the time.
Amit, you don't have to hate everybody, Amit. Love.
Mickey, you're wrong. There's too much love in the world. We have to stop it. You spread love and legs and we will spread the rest.
Love is the single most creative energy and it makes you as creative as me doing Karnapidasan.
But in India, love is just the brother of Kush.
Ah, yeah.
As we are concerned.
And that makes you Kush. I mean, love gives you all the Kushi of the world.
Again, we are going to turn another direction altogether, but I suppose it's allowed.
Okay, no. So, I would say minus the Kush. Love minus the Kush.
Minus, all right.
I want to add that it seems to me at least that that she didn't want to particularly be fallen for this, obviously. But the scamsters took so much effort to basically scam her. They sent like letterheads with the Harvard actual logo.
This is not difficult to do.
With my limited knowledge, will be able to copy paste and put things.
If there are multiple people getting in touch with her, if there are say maybe like 3 people running the scam, then it's easy to fall prey.
Did she get? I seriously doubt that she got multiple emails from a Harvard.
So I know two people. No, 2 people for sure. One person who contacted her initially. For saying that there's an opening, there's a vacancy. Right. And one person who sent the email. So
have they taken any criminal action against these people now?
No, they haven't caught them yet.
Investigated, yeah.
They haven't caught them.
They have fake IDs and also it's going to take years.
It'll take for a while. But again, I'm sympathetic, right? I know people who have gotten scammed online. Right. I mean, like in my family, it's happened, right? Where, you know, you'll get like payment requests and then like people will say, okay, just send a rupee so that we know. And then like, you know, we'll return money and do all this. And this happens. I'm not saying it doesn't happen. Right. Like, you know, 5,000, 10,000 rupee scams have happened like that. People do get scammed online. This just seems like it's such a long drawn out thing. And there are so many different, if you are a journalist, you should be naturally skeptical about things. If you are a target, the way
hindsight,
that she is.
Hindsight.
No, no, dude, she's a target. She's a target.
And all that, and, you know, whatever.
Yeah, so, I mean, people hate her. Like, I mean, like, seriously, she's...
Amit, you have to be blamed for that.
Well, yeah. The other Amit.
I'm not saying that.
No, but she's hated, right? I mean, like, so if you have this degree of, like, you know, this degree of trolling happening to you on a regular basis, I would be a little more... Yeah. But again, it's not me. It's
she's
her.
Hated I mean, by her politics in one side of it, right?
Yeah.
She's also liked, like people of my generation find her very nice and all that, and we've interacted with her. Mickey is swaying towards the other side of the board, so maybe not so fond of her. But I get what you're saying, that you're used to so much hate mail.
I love everybody. I love everybody.
So do I, actually. Making a political difference. Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah, I mean, I don't hate anyone.
Except when they that flatulence in the small room and
that is also acceptance with grace. That is also acceptance with grace.
I heard, let's call them Mr. and Mrs. Sharma discussing it. Array, I passed wind. I'm feeling so much more comfortable. I was like, no, let's not take civilization to such a level. You know, let's have some space, some boundaries. Oh, God. Oh, where do we go? AMAs, bro.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you haven't been following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. I'd like to thank the sponsors on the network this week, Storytel and The Whole Truth Foods. Thank you for supporting us. So, a great bunch of episodes this week. First, let me tell you about The Note with Maruk Inayat. It was featuring Asaduddin Owaisi. She spoke to the AIMIM leader to understand what the Indian Muslim voter wants and how his party is any different from the BJP. On Advertising is Dead, Varun spoke with Malika Sadani. Malika is the founder and CEO of The Moms Company. They discussed the science of motherhood. On Naan Kari with Sadaf and Archit, Dhananjay Chuck of the Edges and Sledges podcast showed up. So we did another crossover, this time with food and cricket. On Agla Station Adulthood, Ritasha and Ayushi talked to Gaurang Sangvi, head of digital business at DSP Mutual Fund. The episode has some logical and realistic advice, especially for millennials, on how to invest their money. Shunya One is back this week with Shiladitya and myself. We spoke to Anirudh Singla of Pepper Content this week. Really interesting conversation. Anirudh gave us some real deep insights into content creation and how they're thinking about different ways of creating it. Do check them out. Really fun show, really fun conversation. And with that, let me get you back to your show.
Follow me at Instagram and Twitter on Board Brocha. I'm so bored, I need your help. I need your love. I need your touch. Okay, just follow me.
All right, AMS. The first one comes in from Marilyn Marpot. Says, please ask Mickey, sir, if the combination of intermittent fasting with exercise can help us in losing weight.
Free consultation. There you go.
That's basically what it is.
Catch the bakla and now get as much from him as possible. Go on.
100%. I'll tell you why. Intermittent fasting is nothing new. The Vedic science speaks about eating once a day. And I've coined some lines on that. Jo ek bar khaye wo yogi, do bar khaye wo bhogi, bar bar khaye wo rogi.
Can I also say, ek bar khaye to, isn't it called poverty?
Sorry. But again, to come back to your earlier Jain thing, like I know that the Jain people, like my mom, right? Again, she stops eating at 5:30 in the evening and she will not eat till 7 o'clock in the next morning. Which
very
is
scientific.
Very
into the dark.
It's the scientific why? Because when the sun rises, our energies rise, our pineal gland controls, regulates the sleep.
It's fair to say there's no investment in Swiggy or Scootsy by the Jain community.
100%.
I guess I'm part of the Jain community in some sense, am I not?
Yes, but you are a rebel. Look at your lifestyle, you awful man. Eating at 11, eating at 3 in the morning, having a drink at 5, and no asana, left, right or center. There is no way, Amit Doshi, we will get a sponsor right now. I will pick up the phone. You put your legs behind your head, show it to us, and I'm telling you right now, ask Mickey Mehta, we will get cross. You'd never have to work again.
Amit, tell me, I'm sure you don't do asanas, but I'm sure you have a lot of asanas.
I don't know what vasana is. Vasana, the dishes.
No, not vasana, vasana, lust for life.
I love life. Vasana. I enjoy, I like doing fun.
Because he is a bloody American.
While Jains talk about upasana, most of this world is involved in vasana. So, you know, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madhu, maya, matsara, pride, anger, lust, envy, gluttony, avarice, sloth. Are your seven sins? Seven vasna.
I love those sins. Please. कुछ तो रखो आम आदमी के लिए कुछ तो रखो भाई प्लीज
प्लीज यू शुड आस्क केजरीवाल वो आम आदमी सब कुछ
सडनली पॉलिटिकल है यू आर ओके विद लेफ्ट एंड राइट बट केजरीवाल फॉर सम रीजन
अरे केजरीवाल कैन नॉट बी फॉरगॉटन बिकॉज़ केजरीवाल के नाम पे देयर इज अ डिश इन विलिंगडन क्लब
करेक्ट नॉट जस्ट विलिंगडन ऑल द साउथ बॉम्बे क्लब्स हैव केजरीवाल एक केजरीवाल इज वेरी पॉपुलर
एक केजरीवाल इज एवरीवेयर नाउ राइट
इट इज एवरीवेयर
बट प्लीज प्लीज अ लीफ वर्थ टेकिंग आउट ऑफ केजरीवाल्स यू नो बुक That he is an adorable, very cute, very lovable man.
I have teddy bears and things like that. Fair enough. Listen. Let's get one more two questions on Mickey for Mickey. Come on.
This one says Tarun Kaushik asks Cyrus and team, based on the current events, please tell how you'd react if your WhatsApp chats were leaked over the internet. What would people find out about you?
Nothing great, but you know, just sometimes you make sexual comments and things like that. What else? Or maybe bitching about personal friends here and there. That kind of shit happens. Yeah. I can't think of anything that will bring the government down, if you're asking that way. I just think, actually, what you say won't upset the general public. I think it just upsets people around you. Because everybody, A and B, always talk about C. You know, that's the problem. So if you go through WhatsApp chats, everybody's got something they're hiding. Yeah. Even the great Mickey Mehta, who obviously is more enlightened than us. I'm sure Mickey, you wouldn't want all your WhatsApp chats revealed, would you?
Well, with all the flirting around, then I do certainly not.
and under the guise of philosophy and, you know, all this, and suddenly, you know, the picture on the DP.
So I have adopted a very, very nice habit of sending hearts to everybody.
Hugs or hearts?
Hearts.
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 You know that the pumping one?
Uh-huh.
Sending hearts to everybody. I
would like people to keep distance, but honestly, I don't understand why. The love has to be curtailed a little bit. Not hate, but not too much love. Too much love is as bad as hate.
Cyrus, love flows like river.
It starts becoming so insincere that everybody says, how's you? How you been? And they don't care about it. Just why do we do that? Stop that. Stop all that, please.
Cyrus, I remember, you know, I mean, out of the context, I remember once, you know, there was some event somewhere, and this was some 25 years back, and you punched Mr. Bachchan in his stomach.
I remember.
He was talking to you.
Was he taking long?
What? You punched Amitabh Bachchan in his stomach?
No, not the way he said it.
Gently.
I mean, like, again, I'm just thinking of Kuli and like accident and stomach.
My God, you've really gone into a hate ordeal thing now. The man who destroyed India's greatest superstar with his loud mouth. Listen, he's been so nice to me. I would never ever do any. What I like about Amitabh Bachchan is that he just, in spite of all his fame, he just becomes your kind of, you know, area of, he falls down to your level. So if you're going to be regressive in your stupid commentary, you know, he does the same. But you know, with a straight poker face, because he's got immaculate comic timing off and on camera. So, in that sense, he's like a Parsi, Mickey?
Ekdam.
Straight face, tuck, he gives it back and nothing ruffles him. But apparently, if he doesn't like you, he's different. So I think I passed the test initially.
I like this dialogue in Amartya Anthony.
Can you assume a position and say it?
Aisa to aadmi life mein do is time bhagne ka sakta
hai. Police ka chase hai Olympic race.
Police ka case ho.
Correct.
Olympic ka race ho ya
police ka chase. Correct.
And his second dialogue, bade bade paper mein apna bhi chota chota photo aata hai.
Wow. Nikki Mehta has gone from where to where? The holistic nature of the universe coming together to represent your health, wealth and everything else. Bollywood dialogues from the 80s. I mean, that's great. Legs spread, legs behind the head. Amit Doshi is so upset. He and me will never ever come to yoga class. All right, just a minute. We're running late. We do one more quickly.
That sounds very awful. One more quickly.
Boss, this is barroom talk. Back in the old days. Ek apni. That's also awful.
And that you had Gwalior Tank, you and Kunal. Gwalior Tank Grand Center, if I'm
Of course.
Chicken Center.
Legends. Yeah. And they called us Baba. I stopped drinking in 2015 and he was 55 or something. Imagine being called Baba all your life. Like, you know. Out of respect. Because we started at 16. It's like that.
Sanju Baba made everything famous.
But it's the same thing. So Sanju Baba was called Baba by the staff when he was 16, 15. But at 58, they should stop it.
Chalo, aur ek aane do.
Last.
This one comes in from Gandhar Parki. This person asks, Dr. Mehta, some gods of Sanatan Dharma used to smoke. Do you think smoking being so dangerous should not have been promoted in such a way?
Well, I would say, would it be appropriate to say God smoke? No. Because God is a phenomenon. God cannot be embodied. Anything that can be embodied, anything that is definite, and anything that can be defined cannot be eternal and cannot be divine.
But controversial jawab nahi chena.
No, not really. It's actually the nicest answer we could have gotten for a question which you're asking.
Giving no figure to an amorphous thing, okay.
Yeah. So let me tell you, divinity exists in principles and not in persons.
Wow, you can see from our awkward silence that we are all wondering how to go with this. And honestly, it's not because, it's only because of a sense of fear. The moment you turn to religion of any kind and religious sort of diatribe, I think immediately all of us pull out a little bit. Because I one think, young Munawar Farooqi is lying, doing yoga positions.
So apparently, dude, they want to arrest him in UP now.
But okay, last
they already NFP.
No, so they sent a warrant. So UP has asked him to appear in court now.
Wow.
Okay, lastly on this question. So ever since, you know, life was spotted on the rims of a volcano, which is called chemolitho autotrophic hyperthermophile, to the point we've become conscious.
Let's try it.
Chemolitho autotrophic hyperthermophile. So right from that point, 14 billion years, we've evolved and we've become super conscious human beings who have the potential of rising above gods and falling below animals. So that answers the question of your smoking, drinking, eating.
And nothing rhyming.
Seeing, being, doing.
All right. Let's end this nice discussion with Silvery doing a asana of his choice. Just to show the young are also interested in yoga. You're reaching with a pad.
This is arm asana.
Yeah, correct.
This is a Brisbane test match giving a decision. That's what it is. The umpire. All right. Okay. Vicky, thanks for being here. And now it's back to normal life for me, walking dogs, for Amit getting ready to go to office, and for Silvery looking for a lady.
And for me, opening up.
I would say close down, close a little bit, too much.
So I think my closing parting lines would be my, you know, very standard, but they are very close to me. My 10 commandments are that make wellness your religion, number one. Start a wellness revolution for human evolution. Number two, best exercise for biceps is to uplift the poor. Best exercise for strong shoulders is to take responsibilities of the underprivileged. Best exercise for strong legs is to be rooted in humility, to be better rooted in humanity. Sleep every night with a wish to heal yourself. Wake up every morning with a promise to heal the world. And then you can get energized, maximized, optimized, naturalized, eternalized, internalized, evolutionized, revolutionize, specialize, synergize, synchronize, initialize, regularize, revitalize, all negativity neutralized to get Mickey-mized.
Mickey, great, but just one thing I'd like to say also for my few listeners, and that is that when you're peeing on a highway, don't face the cars. I've noticed that this is a stupid thing to do, and people are now taking photographs, so always face away.
I think obviously, between our two. Isn't that obvious? I mean, we pee in the grass. Not with the car.
They just face anyway, they do this bindas thing, it has to end now. Someone has to take a stand.
That would be so exciting to see. I mean, I'm straight up.
Free Willy coming soon. Free Mickey coming soon. You've scandalized my Mr. Doshi, huh? He's wondering whether you're a philosopher or a rascal. He's caught now between the two.
So thanks. Jokes about Mickey. Great. Don't get Mickey Mouse. Yeah.
Now get Mickey Mouse soon. We'll see you.
Cyrus, only you and you only would have got this out of me. Trust me.
You mean you spread your legs for no one, Mickey?
Although I worked in Muscat for a year.
Political correctness too, take away. Suddenly, every 5 minutes, I have to worry now again. We have to put a disclaimer on this show, Baba. I might be going to Dubai, by the way. Lovely place. See you guys.
See you guys. Good luck.
Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps, please. We beg you, we need you. Send us your questions on Twitter, on Cyrus Says In. Or you can email us, even if you're not female, on whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
Want to learn something new and have a few minutes to spare? Well, then go for The Traveling Professor's Diary, where I, Siddharth Deshmukh, the traveling professor, will help you glean from all the insights that I've gained from wherever I've traveled, learned, taught, and repeated. Join me every Tuesday and Thursday on the IVM Podcast website, app, or wherever you get your podcasts from.
What are some of the radical changes that are now shaping our workspace? With physical distancing and heightened safety protocols being the norm, will technology finally make its large-scale entry to the workspace? Will design as we know it change for the long term? Is it possible for the Indian commercial real estate space to adopt a 360-degree approach to sustainability? Join our hosts at the Future of Space podcast by RMZ as we deliberate with industry leaders, analysts, and bright young minds on the way forward for the workspace given the new COVID normal. Tune in to the IVM Podcasts app or wherever you stream your favorite podcasts